Hello students, welcome to Standard 10th Mathematics Chapter 15 Probability. After knowing all the examples before, we will start in Lecture 15 the exercise 15.1. Only one exercise given in this chapter. All the examples we have completed and you have to complete it on your notebook also. You have to write it all and understanding well, you will also be able to solve this exercise. But then also somewhat I have started and you have to finish it. The question one is, complete the following statement. It is probability of an event E plus probability of an event not E equals to dash. So what will come here? So in solution, you know that probability of event E is denoted as PE plus probability of the event not E is denoted by PE bar, and in the theory we have seen PE plus PE bar equals to 1. So here the answer will be 1. As E and E bar are complementary events. Second number we have the probability of an event that cannot be happened. The probability which is not happening, that probability is called 0. The probability of the event which is not happening is 0, and such an event is called impossible event. You know, the event which is not happening, that type of events are called impossible events. Right? Similarly, the probability of an event that is certain to happen, in theory we have seen, is 1. Probability of sure or certain event is 1. That, and such an event is called sure or certain events. Sure or certain, any word you can use. Certain event. Fourth, we have the sum of probabilities of all the elementary events of an experiment is, this is also we have seen earlier in the example 1, 2, 3, that the sum of the probabilities of all elementary events of an experiment is 1. The probability of fifth number, the probability of event is greater than or equal to and less than or equal to dash. For this, in the theory we have seen, for the probability of any event PE, 0 less than or equal to PE less than or equal to 1. What is this means? The probability of any event will be greater than or equal to 0 less than or equal to 1. So greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to. This will come back. Now question 2 we have, which of the following experiments have equally likely outcomes? Some experiments are given, 4 experiments are given in the question, and we have to identify that which experiments are showing equally likely. Equally likely means having equal chance to happen everything. And we have to explain also. So the first is, a driver attempts to start a car. And the car starts or does not start. This is the situation here. Experiment. A driver attempts to start a car. The car starts or does not start. This way, the statement we have. So this statement is not equally likely. Why? Since he is a driver, one thing. When a driver attempts to start a car, rarely it does not start. The car will, many times it will start, rarely it will not start. So starting or not starting is not equal. Starting will be many times and not starting will be rare. So what do you say? It is not equally likely. Second number, again the same way. A player attempts to shoot a basketball. She or he shoots or misses the shot. Player is there, he or she is trying to shoot a basketball. She may shoot, she may miss, or he, any player, boy or girl. So it is again not equally likely. Again the same argument, since he or she is a player. Player means some expertness will be there. Since when a player attempts to shoot, he or she rarely misses. Means he or she, the player, missing will be rare and shooting will be many times. So it is not equally likely. Third number, a trial is made to answer a true false question. The answer is right or wrong. Means we are trying to give an answer of the question which is of the type right or wrong we have to say. True or false we have to say. And we are randomly saying true or false because it is a trial. So it is equally likely because no reason behind it to give the answer. Just you have to say true or false. It is a trial. So equally likely it is, since it is a trial, the answer may be right or may be wrong because it is a trial. No, with the reason the answer was not given. So it is equally likely. Maybe right, 50% it will be right, 50% it will be wrong. So equally likely. Similarly, the fourth, a baby is born, it is a boy or a girl. It is also equally likely, since when a baby born, no one can predict that the baby which is going to be born will be boy or girl. It is 50-50 chances of being a boy or girl. So it may be a boy or a girl, so equally likely. So this way we have started 15.1 question 1 and 2 I have solved. You also write down this all. And then from question number 3 to end, you have to solve every question, each and every question you will solve. And if you are finding some difficulty anywhere, you will see, you will refer the last videos and examples in which all the examples we have discussed, all the examples we have understood. By the help of that, you can surely complete the exercise. Right? So complete the exercise, this is your homework now. Okay. Complete the exercise and this chapter will be